Number 13, the E-Governance Act. It promotes the use of internet, and other ICT to provide opportunities for citizens. Number 14, the National Land Use Act. This will provide for a rational and holistic management and development of our country's land and water resources, hold owners accountable for making these lands productive and sustainable, strengthen the LGU to manage ecological balance within its jurisdiction. It also provides for land use and physical planning framework as a mechanism in determining policies and principles to implement this legislative measure. Number 15, the National Defense Act. This seeks to amend the antiquated National Defense Act of 1935 to provide for a change in the military structure of the Armed Forces of the Philippines that is more responsive to current and future non-conventional security threats to the country's territorial integrity and national sovereignty. Number 16, Mandatory Reserve Officers Training Corps and National Service Training Program. This seeks to reinstitute the ROTC program as a mandatory component of senior high school programs, grades 11 and 12, in all public and private tertiary level educational institutions. The aim is to motivate, train, organize, and mobilize students for national defense preparedness, including disaster preparedness and capacity building for risk-related situations. Number 17, enactment of an enabling law for the natural gas industry. This seeks to foster the development of the midstream natural gas industry in a bid to strengthen Philippine energy security by diversifying the country's primary sources of energy and promoting the role of natural gas as a complementary fuel to variable renewable energy. Number 18, amendments to the Electric Power Industry Reform Act, or EPIRA. This aims to improve the implementation of the law's provisions and enhance its effectiveness to address the high cost of electricity, alleged market collusion, and insufficient power supply. The bill seeks to restructure the Energy Regulation Commission to foster accountability and improve the Commission's government system that would ensure consumer protection and in enhancing competitive operation of the electricity market. Number 19, amendments to the Build, Operate, Transfer Law. This seeks to improve the implementation of the public-private partnership program and to be able to direct the desired outputs and outcomes in line with the strategic development targets of the country. Specifically, the amendments seek to, 1, address the ambiguities in the existing law. 2, address the bottlenecks and challenges affecting the implementation of the PPP program. And 3, foster a more competitive and enabling environment for PPPs.